हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ श्वेता गुगे, थर्ड ईयर MBBS स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम GMC गोंदिया। हियर आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट अ केस फॉर नेशनल लेवल केस प्रेजेंटेशन कंपटीशन डॉक्टर शेरलॉक द साइंस ऑफ डिडक्शन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय डॉक्टर PKSN मेडिकल फोरम GMC गोंदिया।
लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द केस। द गिवन केस इज अ 29 ईयर ओल्ड पेरेंट्स वुमन दैट इज G5P4 एट 39 वीक्स ऑफ जेस्टेशन विद प्री एक्लेम्पशिया डिलीवर्स वजाइनली। So according to the given case, we have a 29-year-old Paris woman who has delivered vaginally at 39 weeks of gestation and was having preeclampsia. Her prenatal course has been complicated except for asymptomatic bacteriuria caused by E. coli in first trimester treated with oral cephalexin. She denies a family history of bleeding diathesis. After the placenta is delivered, there is appreciable vaginal bleeding estimated as 1000 ml. So, there is no family history of bleeding diathesis and after the vaginal delivery, there is appreciable bleeding of 1000 ml. Let's understand the case first. The key findings of the case are G5P4, that is Gravida 5 and Paridi 4. Gravida is number of times a female has conceived, in which we include the present pregnancy. Paridi is number of pregnancies beyond 20 weeks, in which we not count the present pregnancy. This multiparity is one of the predisposing factors for the causation of postpartum hemorrhage. The woman delivered at 39 weeks. Therefore, it is a term pregnancy because it is beyond 37 weeks. The woman presented with preeclampsia. Preeclampsia is increase in blood pressure during pregnancy or after delivery. The placenta is delivered, which means there is no residual placenta which is left behind. The bleeding, talking about bleeding diathesis, bleeding diathesis is tendency to bleed. In the given case, it is absent. Vaginal bleeding is estimated as 1000 ml. Vaginal bleeding after delivery called postpartum bleeding. Now let's know about the normal blood loss to identify abnormal. In vaginal delivery, it is less than 500 ml. In cesarean section, it is less than 1000 ml. In twin delivery, it is less than 1000 ml. And in cesarean hysterectomy, it is less than 1500 ml. In any case of blood loss more than that of expected value in 24 hours of delivery or up to 12 weeks of delivery called as postpartum hemorrhage. This is according to the definition given by WHO. But according to American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists, blood loss greater than or equal to 1000 ml irrespective of mode of delivery is called as postpartum hemorrhage. In present case, bleeding after vaginal delivery is 1000 ml, which is more than 500 ml. So, it is the case of postpartum hemorrhage. Postpartum hemorrhage can be because of various causes. Moving to the first part of the case, that is differential diagnosis. The various causes of postpartum hemorrhage are decreased tone of uterus, that is atonic uterus, trauma due to perineal tear, cervical tear or ruptured uterus. It can be caused due to decreased thrombin level or other bleeding disorder or retained placental tissue. The most common cause of postpartum hemorrhage is atonic uterus and the second most common cause of postpartum hemorrhage is trauma. Coming to the next part, now how we can clinically approach this case? We need to palpate the uterus perabdominally. If the uterus is not palpable, the reason of PPH is due to decreased tone of uterus called atonic uterus. And if the uterus is palpable, that which means the tone of the uterus is normal. In such case, we need to look for lacerations or tear due to trauma on vaginal side walls and cervix. If it is present, the reason of PPH will be trauma. And if it is not present or absent, the reason can be retained placental tissue or bleeding disorders. To check retained placental tissue, we can do pervaginal examination and rule it out. And to check blood bleeding disorders, we can check the thrombin levels. But in the present case, there is no finding of laceration or trauma, no history of bleeding diathesis, no retained placenta. So we can rule out the bleeding due to above three conditions. She was having preeclampsia, which can progress to eclampsia, that is increase in blood pressure and seizures. She must have given magnesium sulfate, which is a drug of choice in terms of treatment and prophylaxis for eclampsia. Magnesium sulfate causes uterine relaxation, which in turn leads to atonicity of uterus. So the most likely diagnosis of the given case is postpartum hemorrhage due to uterine atony. Postpartum hemorrhage is defined as primary or secondary depending upon whether it occurs within 24 hours of delivery or after that period. The most common cause of primary postpartum hemorrhage is uterine atony, in which bleeding is arising from placental implantation site, in which the uterus feels boggy or coming to the last and most important part of the case, that is management. How will we manage the patient of postpartum hemorrhage? When the patient comes with bleeding, we have to take immediate measures and resuscitate the patient. Call for extra help, involve obstetric registrar on call, put into large bore IV cannulas, rapidly infuse normal saline containing crystalloids and hemacell containing colloids of 2 liters, then catheterize the bladder to monitor urine emptying or urine output, then check the vitals, pulse, blood pressure, temperature, respiratory rate, etc. If the uterus remains atonic, give uterotonic drug that are injectional oxytocin 10 to 20 units in 500 ml of normal saline. Also massage the uterus simultaneously. Give injectional methargine 0.2 mg intravenously. If still bleeding persists, give either of 15-methyl PGF-2-alpha 250 microgram intramuscularly or misoprostol 1000 microgram per rectal or injectional carbetocin 1000 microgram intramuscularly or intravenously. If bleeding is still present, the bleeding can be prevented by mechanical methods. That is, balloon of normal capacity 300 to 500 ml is placed in the uterus through vagina and normal saline is injected in it through syringe. It gets deployed and this creates a uterine tamponading effect which prevents the bleeding. The bleeding can also be prevented by bimanual compression of uterus, in which uterus is compressed between two hands. One hand is placed vaginally, which is clenched into fist, and the other hand is placed over the abdomen behind the uterus. Also, tight intrauterine packing is done under anesthesia, but it is not recommended by WHO. If mechanical methods also fails, we have to go for surgical methods. The surgical methods are B. Lynch compression suture, in which both anterior and posterior walls of uterus comes closer as if it tighten the suture, so that there is no blood loss through vaginal opening. The other methods are ligation of uterine artery and utero-ovarian anastomotic vessels, ligation of anterior division of internal iliac artery, angiographic arterial embolization with gelatin sponge. If still bleeding is present, we have to go for hysterectomy, and second best method is total abdominal hysterectomy, in which we remove uterus as well as cervix. That's done with the given case. Thank you.